Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day. Don't forget, grab your smartphone and download the Lava Matra app and stay in touch. Guru Maharaj's message is your advantage.
Today is push.
Jayadeva Goswami.
I composed the Gita Govinda and a number of address Avatar Sutra, a number of great poems of our time. So at one time he was staying in the in the kingdom. At that time, Alal Sen or Lakshman Sen? One of the two. And you see, in those days, Brahmins had a certain stature in society. Although they were poor, in many cases, but they held the respect of the kings. So, but somehow his poetry was so outstanding that the king personally went to see him to offer him a chance to offer him the ministership as, or a kind of a special status as a state poet. So, but Ajayi did something very unexpected. He said, how is this that a kshatriya, a king, has come to see me without asking my permission? Because of this, I'm leading Navadi. So, the king said, well, I'm sorry if I transgressed any etiquette. I serve you, I have all respect for you. Please don't leave the kingdom. If you said you would leave, now just so. There's nothing I can do about that. But, at least go to the other side of the river and stay in my kingdom. So, at that time, he stayed in Chathahati, which was later Gargadhar Ashram was there. He stayed sometime in Chathahati, and he was composing some literature then. So, it says that he allowed the king to go and see him sometime. So, one night, he was writing a poem where Kṛṣṇa, he had bowed down to Rādhārāṇī and begged her forgiveness. And he thought of this anyhow. How can I write such a thing? Because Kṛṣṇa is Supreme Lord, Rādhārāṇī is energy. I shouldn't have such a thing. So then he went out to bathe, and again, it's, at that time, he came back to his house and filled in me. He sat down to me, began to compose again. Then he said that he wanted to set up. He took a little prasad from his wife, and then he set up. The real Jayadeva came back from the Ganges, and the wife said, "What's happening? You were just here." "I wasn't here, I was in the Ganges." "No, you were just here. You sat down, you wrote something, you took a song of sound." He went down and he saw. It's written, Kṛṣṇa bowed down to Rādhārāṇī and begged her. So, that was Kṛṣṇa. That was Kṛṣṇa who came. This guy is a thing. He had the most portion lady in the world. You saw Kṛṣṇa, you served Kṛṣṇa. So, she said, "Oh, I thought it was you." "No, no, it was Kṛṣṇa. I was in the Ganges." So, like this, Jayadeva was a very special devotee. After that, Jagannath came in his dream and told him to go to the Jagannath Puri. So he left and he went to Jagannath Puri with his wife. And there he composed the Ardasa Avatar Stotra. Glorifying the Lord Jagannath, glorifying Lord our Krishna, Krishna. So, when you go to the, on the Parikrama, we always stop at Chattahati, at the, Gorgadara Temple, and then we remember Jayadeva or Swami, pastimes there. So, Jayadeva or Swami King.
Yeah. Any question?
Yeah. You wrote any question on your title? What is this? Blank. Please,
there's a question here.
Give him a seat, he's how about the sign?
There's a chair there, we can bring that over. There's a question here, Guru Maharaj. Somebody's asking why Krishna disguised himself as Jayadeva? Because he didn't get the story.
It's written. Jayadeva was trying to understand, he had this vision that Krishna was bowing down to Rādhārāṇī. This is the famous pastime of Man Bunchen. But he hesitated to write. So,
what's the name of the pastime, Guru Maharaj?
Man Bunchen.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Man means like anger,
yeah.
Pride.
Bunchen.
So, Krishna, in his pastime of Rādhārāṇī, sometimes takes the subordinate role. But he hesitated to write that. So Krishna Krishna came as disguised as Jayadeva to be able to write this in his book that is true. Krishna sometimes takes a subordinate role to Rādhārāṇī because of her pure love for him.
And this was a
Special way of blessing his wife, blessing him, and revealing this confidential truth. If Krishna would have come as Krishna, he couldn't have done that. His wife would have, you know, got hysterical or something. All over herself. What to do, what to do, how to send him. She couldn't just go on right now.
Dearest Maharaj, could you please tell a story of Lord Dāmodara with further running? Thank you. Jagat Kirti Devidasa.
Tell a story.
Could you please tell a story of Lord Dāmodara with Rādhārāṇī?
I just saw he didn't say particularly Lord Dāmodara.
Just small Krishna, but small one.
I don't know at what age, but at some age, Durvasa Muni blessed Rādhārāṇī that everything she cooked would be nectar. So as a result, Rādhārāṇī Muni or someone suggested to Yasoda that since Durvasa Muni had blessed Rādhārāṇī in this way, that she should cook for Krishna. So at a certain age, she started to cook for Krishna under the guidance of another soul.
How can we be?
One more question. Jayadeva, who was his spiritual master? Jayadeva. Jayadeva the Swami, who was his guru? They're asking.
I don't know him. Anyone else on here?
There's another question in the internet. Why did Lord Caitanya take sannyasi from Keśava Bhārati, even though he was not a Vaishnava and a sannyasi from Mayavadi school? This is from Durali Lejra from Malaysia.
Who is your question from?
Mathura Lileshwari from Malaysia.
Okay. Why did Lord Krishna, why did Lord Caitanya take sannyas initiation from Keśava Bhārati, although he was a sannyas in the Shankaracharya school, and he was a devotee, and at that time in North India there were no sannyasis other than the Caitanya, Shankaracharya school. It was very rare that Maharaja Puri, he had come to North India, although he was a sannyasi from the another school. Of course, taking sannyas is not quite the same as taking the first or second initiation. Taking initiation is much more serious. connection. Taking sannyas is less, is more like a priest. Now, someone states that because of Lord Caitanya takes sannyas from the Shankara school, that gives him some access to the Shankara Acharya following sannyasis. They took him as one of them. So, and it gives him an opportunity to preach, which otherwise he would not have gotten. Whether that was one of the issues, it's hard to say, but that's what some pundits venture. In any case, there is no other person. It says Lord Caitanya, he asked Keśava Bhārati, is this the mantra you're going to give me? And then he said the sannyas mantra in his ear. He said, oh yes, I'll give you that one. So actually Lord Caitanya gave him the mantra and it's too good there. So he really initiated Keśava Bhārati and then took the mantra back from him. Jai Caitanya Mahaprabhu ki
Jai.
How we can become empowered to do some creative work for Krishna, like writing books. Your servant, Teja Gaurangi.
How can we be empowered to do something greater for Krishna? Well, you ask your husband. Something creative every day. He creates these nice preparations. He's such a good cook. He creates all kinds of culinary delights for Jayadeva Krishna. So, I mean, creative work may be in different ways. Personally reading, or writing rather, personally cooking, personally dressing the deities, some, what else? We got here, Triambulas, he cooks. I heard the restaurant is a hit because of the cooking. We got Toshini Lakti Vidyati, she dresses the deities. So some, is it right?
She cooks also.
Oh, she cooks so. So, was there Kitty, she dressed the deity?
I did Mangalarati and made Paraphernalia to use.
So, of course, we can pray to Krishna. We can pray to him and please bless me that I can write this book and I can do this service. So, before we do the service, we go to Krishna. Go to the Guru and we take his blessings and we can do that particular service successfully.
In the history of the hunter and Narada Muni in Chaitanya Charitamrita, the hunter was in ecstasy in chanting the holy names before his spiritual master, despite the terrible sins that he committed. Can you kindly elaborate on this wonderful pastime, Guru Maharaj? This is from Rati Gopika from Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia.
Does anyone have a question or internet?
Well, in English is written on camera.
Is anybody watching us from Russia?
Yes,
please ask for a blessing or send us a blessing or something.
59 beers we have.
Huh?
59 beers.
No, I don't think a deer.
Viewers.
Beer, beer? Beer, beer.
Yeah,
yeah.
We have 10 in English on Skype.
Viewers.
They keep asking for blessings, Guru Maharaj. I said blessings come at the end, right?
Yeah.
Along with the cookies. Okay. Now there's a question related.
Wait, wait, he has an answer.
I'm sorry.
Question.
Ramaj, the question was, in the story of the hunter and Narada Muni in Chaitanya Charitamrita, the hunter was in ecstasy in chanting the holy names before his spiritual master, despite the terrible sins he committed. Can you kindly elaborate on this wonderful pastime, Guru Maharaj? Rati Gopika from Kuala Lumpur.
Thank you. Rati Gopika from Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Let's see now. When the guru takes the disciple, or when he initiates the disciple, the disciple is freed from sins. So when that hunter took initiation from Narada Muni and also and took vows, so he became a vegetarian. He didn't take any intoxication. He didn't have any illicit relation, just had his wife. And what else? He didn't gamble. So he was a changed person. He was no longer a sinful hunter. He was a Krishna conscious devotee. So it doesn't matter. I mean, many of our devotees some of our devotees, me included, are sinners before we met the Krishna consciousness, and by the mercy of Prabhupada, we were initiated and we were engaged in his devotional service, and as a result, he freed us from the sins of our previous life. So it was with the hunter, who got initiation from such an empowered acharya like Narada Muni, who is a Shakta Vish avatar of the Lord. He's called a Dila Rishi or Dilarshi Maharaj, and he's already a liberated soul. Once Ravana tried to control him and said, if you don't do what I say, I'll kill you. And I already did. I'm already dead, and I have a spiritual body. So Ravana took out his sword and kind of put the sword right through Narada. Nothing happened. He had again, and again, nothing happened. So Narada laughed, ha ha ha, I'm already dead. You can't kill me. So Narada Muni, he was a liberated soul, and when the universe was in the night of Brahma, and all living entities were sucked into the Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. And Narada, he went into the Garbhodakshaya Vishnu, and there he just lied silent the whole day of Brahma. Now, that's a long time. He was awake, but he just, for eternal living entity, a night of Brahma is not much. That's quick. Jai Narayana Ki.
They're asking about, you know, how you said that taking sannyasa is not as serious as taking first initiation or second initiation. Can you elaborate on that? What's your name? Kaveri? Yeah, Kaveri.
You see, a second initiation, first and second, they link us with the Guru Parampara. And the Guru takes the commitment to take us back to Godhead. Whereas the taking of sannyas is a kind of a, well, it's a little more than a priestly activity, but not much. So, like Prabhupada, he was initiated by Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. So he's considered a disciple of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. But he took sannyas from a case of Pragya.
Bhakti Pragya.
Bhakti Pragya. Akesha Maharaj. So, he, Prabhupada also, I heard the exact words he used, but he said, although this is not the same thing as his taking initiation from Bhakti Sthana, I still he held him in respect and he offered some prayers to him. So, maybe I have more sannyas disciples than any other guru in ISKCON. But that doesn't mean that, and they all consider themselves to be those who are Prabhupada disciples. They consider themselves to be Prabhupada disciples, and the fact that I'm a sannyas guru, it's one of the things in the way, and it's not so important for them as compared with their relationship with Śrīla Prabhupāda. Maybe if I knew that they were having some difficulty with their sannyas, I could approach them and I could try to help them. That's about the extent of my relationship as a sannyas, a guru with them.
Hare Krishna, please accept my humble obeisances of glories to Srila Prabhupada. Could you please tell us what is the best way to surrender to Krishna? Angelica.
Well, what's the best way to surrender to Krishna? Krishna describes this in the Gita, he describes it in different scriptures. In the Gita, 18th chapter, he says,
She's got an accent.
She's got an accent.
didn't.
So, here Krishna gives four activities. Manmana, Atikami, Malinamashko, offering obeisances. Mandrak told the Kalmani devotee. He is devotee, pardon him, pray to him, I think of him. And this is how Krishna, in the Gita he describes, in the next verse he says, Sarvajara Pitkaja, Bhagavan Kamsanamaja. He loves all the other religion and simply surrender to me. In the nectar of devotion, Sri Swami talks that one should take shelter of the glorified spiritual master, should take initiation from our spiritual master, should follow the teachings of Shiksha, of the glorified spiritual master. Like that, because the 10 things are most important. So, six of the 10 are in relation to the Guru. That's not the 5th or 6th chapter of the first part of the Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, of the nectar of devotion. There are 6 tenths of surrender of vengeance. So, like this, we probably get the most practical advice how to surrender to Krishna in the nature of devotion. That gives us some very specific activities we can do.
Cookies. Blessings. They're asking for blessings. Monica from Chile, the one who made the nice drawing for you.
Monica from Chile.
Yeah, it's come on.
No.
Please tell where your letters.
Gracias por las batas. Las batas locas.
¿Por qué?
Llamas.
Batas.
Batas.
Locas.
Who has the photos?
Photos. I have the drawings that she made. I have.
You should show the devotees here.
I will.
And then see. You saw? How many saw those drawings?
Prema Sindhu Chaitanya from Argentina also is asking blessings. Prema Sindhu Chaitanya from Argentina is asking blessings.
Prema Sindhu Chaitanya from Argentina, blessings.
Lila
Mohini, blessings.
She's asking for blessings to get Sheila. She wants someone to give her. So you bless her, so she might get one, too.
She took second?
No.
Not yet.
Not yet.
Not yet.
Terrible.
I told you, no second, no shield.
No, no, no.
Second, first, then shield.
Shield.
Thank you for watching our videos. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day. And don't forget to like and share our channel.